na gaishe ku da wannan safe da kalmomin Yesu da ya faɗa cewa ya kare. Every year on this day, we usually gather, as we know very well, to read the story of the suffering of our Lord Jesus Christ and to reflect on his crucifixion, crucifixion and death on the cross. This year, we are marking Good Friday in a situation where the whole world is in a sense locked down due to the coronavirus pandemic. As many would say, we are at war, and the war can never be won unless we all stand together in prayers, and stand together in common action, governments, and civilians, military men, women, old and young. We must resolve to stand together to do what we can do to halt the spread of the virus. And we have seen the havoc that this virus is causing around the world. It's never the responsibility of just one person, it is our collective responsibility. But wherever you are gathering this morning, whether at home or in small groups, I want to welcome you to Good Friday worship. Kamanda Musa bakuwa ni shekara muka kadu haka mwiti karatu da kachitundi haki mutariki mutila bari wahala da Yesu yasa wa kuma kiche da mutuwa za. Ama bana wa haka basa kida yana yida kute chiki kuma yadama dole wa haka hanu domi mwina sa. Yesterday afternoon, we commemorated the events of the night before Jesus died. We commemorated Jesus' last meal with his disciples, during which time he gave them a new commandment: love one another as I have loved you. Today, as we gather, we meditate on the death of Jesus, and we call this in English Good Friday. But I don't think all those who were standing there on that fateful day would have called this day a Good Friday, because it was bloody. It was full of hate and anger. It was full of denial and abandon. It was full of lies and deceit. So in a sense, if we look very carefully what happened on that day, it is very difficult to understand literally why we call it Good Friday. But for the fact that Jesus' suffering and death was meant to accomplish God's divine plan for our peace, for our reconciliation with God, and for our eternal rest, this is what makes it good. This is the good news. So we can call it Friday, a Good Friday. Idan mun taru wannan rana a Hausa ce ban san yadda zan sa ki ba, amma da Turanci ana ce Good Friday, wato Juma'a mai kyau. Hausa ne dai ya ba mu juyi mai kyau, Juma'a ta azaba Yesu, amma da Turanci ana ce Good Friday, Juma'a mai kyau. Kuma idan muka duba muka yi tunani mai kyau, a wancan rana abubuwan da su faru yana da wuya mu fahimta don ne a turance za a ce wannan juma mai kyau. Domin ya fi kyau mu kira shi bakar juma kawai. Domin abin da za mu karanta nan na bakin ciki ne kawai, inda Yahuda ya fara da bashin da Yesu, inda an ko an kama shi, inda Filibus yana Musa ta bai san shi ba, inda Yesu ya zama yabena a yi shi kadai abokanansa sun gudu, inda aka yi masa dukkan karya, inda gaskiya ba amfani, domin matan Filibus ta so ta faɗa ma Filibus ka yi hankali da mutumin nan, When he was introduced in John 1:27, it says, "Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world." As a lamb, he will be crucified. He will die a terrible death. In fact, when Jesus was entering Jerusalem on Palm Sunday, he knew precisely what was going to happen. He knew it. Yet, he chose to walk in to confront the powers of darkness rather than walk away from it. So he knew. It was not by surprise. DJs the Domas and the Mamashiva, Bakuma, Neva, and Domas and the Shiva, the Sanisa, Yasa design, Yasani, Tumhan, Wansa, Tulok, and Tulaka, and Sama Kusma, who will say, Duba, and Ragona, Allah, my Alkan, Zuluba, Mutan, Yasani, that teaches Yahuna and Kasha. So, what I have, Raman, the Shiva, and Shalima, and Kanjaki, what the woman has said, she lacked the Paris and Dakin, and a waka fires, hallelujah, Hosanna, and down. Yet she asked me, Karisha, what a waka, they do ya to a Buta, they do ya to a Chuta, they do ya to a Ula Kachi, they pay the kitchen, they pay the Mutua. And my yes, you have the advice. She got to keep building in Kalima, Yapuskanchi, Puska, the Puska. Equal, no Mututa, the Nadu. Equal Mutua, the Zulu. Domine Yantaka. Therefore, when the last moment of his life came, he had completed God's vision and message to humankind. It is finished. He showed us what it means to obey to the last point. It is finished. It is finished. He reminds us that we cannot add anything to the work of our salvation. Yakari. Kalmomi na yakari yesu na tuna mana dakadambe iya yakara kumi. Be iya yi kumi kuma domi aiki che tonsa. Angama. Nohaka muna raiwa agar kashin alheri. Muna raiwa kasih jengkai, muna raiwa akan kasih gapa, muna raiwa akan kasih yaiki. Wanda, Yesu ya Bapa, kau ini kuat. And we can live with courage in the face of fears and anxiety, even in the uncertain situation we find ourselves today, because it is finished. Work of salvation is finished. Evil has its own limitation. And because evil has its own limitation, we can live with courage. Even in the face of fears and anxiety and all kinds of uncertainties today. Almost every media today, the predominant theme is about coronavirus. It is about isolation. It is about distancing, physical and social distancing. It is about lockdown. These languages and terminologies are very terrifying, and they can tear us apart. But with Christ, the victor who shouted on the cross, "It is finished, it is finished," yes, we can also shout in anticipation that it will come to an end. The one that shouted on the cross will take in charge. He's still in charge and will lead us to victory. Saboda Yesu yake ya kare yau zamu rayu ba a cikin tsoro ba amma a cikin ƙarfin hali zamu yi tsayayya da ikon duhu a cikin ƙarfin hali a cikin sani kuma cewa ba zai yashe ba. But it also reminds us how to live, how to move, and how to love. It was love that took Jesus all this journey until the end. And he teaches us to love. To love God, to love one another, to love our neighbors. Yes, even our enemies, as Jesus showed us yesterday, by stooping down and washing the feet of Judas.
To leave Christianity under the finished work of Christ is to let the Spirit of Christ be in us and through us daily. What today, what Good Friday is doing is to invite us to live under the leadership of the Holy Spirit because Christ has overcome. We live under the leadership of Christ who has done it. He has finished it, not doing. Our doing alone does not take us to salvation. We live who we are. We are called to live who we are. And who are we? We are children of God for whom Christ died, who have been liberated and set free. So we live with the freedom of this salvation. We are called to be like Christ, and that we too can be his witnesses in the world. We are called to be salt and light. We are called to be healing to a world that is so broken in its relationships and its differences. We are called to stand different in the world. Listen, there is something strange that happened on this Good Friday. And there is something more evil about the power of a mob. When these people all put their voices together, crucify him, crucify him. Even Pilate, and even Pilate's wife, who knew that Jesus was innocent, they gave up to the voice of the masses. So sometimes, the voice of the masses is an expression for the desire for justice. But sometimes the voice of the masses can also be dangerous. When the masses join together for the sake of tribalistic accomplishment, for the sake of religious differences and sentiments, for the sake of destruction, for the sake of perpetuating injustice and hate, the mass can become a problem. It is precisely when the whole world around us is walking in the powers of darkness that we are called to walk in the powers of the light. And that is not easy, but that is the calling that we have. Because Jesus has overcome and has finished, we are called also to walk as people whose salvation has been accomplished. So at the same time, we know that love, to love like Jesus did, is costly. To love is costly. It cost Jesus to come down to his knees, and it cost him his life. It was because Jesus insisted on love and justice that he was crucified. He was not crucified because he did something wrong. So love is costly. So for us as Christians, to love as Jesus loved, we must know that it is very costly. It can attract enmity. It can attract hatred. It can attract jealousy. It can attract the forces of darkness because light and darkness do not go together. But at the same time, living under the finished work of the Christ of the cross reminds us in times of overwhelming difficulties, we are not alone. When we are overwhelmed by problems and challenges in this life, we must be reminded that we are not alone. The one who said it is finished, and who shouted the song of victory is with us, will walk with us, will hold us, will accompany us all the days of our lives into eternity. Yalikuwa na chini Kristi, jashike Yesu yae nasara nyaki la yeye muma mwini la yuwa kamani ata nasara atikuwa na yuni. Mwini la yuwa bishaka kwa ya wansa. Kamani yende yae kaona faka muma sayi mwini kaona ama musani kaona kana dekadati. Kaona baka kamani. Kaona siya sa Yesu hari ya iya kasakatakan saya, duduk saya, wajib saya wajib kalman jiransa. Harga wajib yang isu. Sebuah yang kaunan, dokumen
Let us pray.